of unplugging. How did you go without your phone for an entire day? I would die.
Lots of wine. No, I'm just kidding. Let's be honest, Jennifer. There wasn't much going on last March. I mean, come on. I was able to, you know, so the National Day of Unplugging comes up this Friday. It starts at sundown on Friday, and then it will go to sundown on Saturday. And the idea is to take a break from your phone, connect with your family, just live stress-free from notifications for 24 hours of your life. Yes, it sounds really hard, and it is, because guess what? Use your phone for your calendar, use it to game, use it to keep up with people, text messaging, maps, look up stuff on the internet, recipes, whatever. But you just go 24 hours without that, your brain will feel better, your relationships will feel better, your sleep will feel better. And I was able to do it, and believe me, Jennifer, I carry around like 2 or 3 phones. So I put them all away, and I just connected with my family, and I'm glad it took a year before I have to do it again on this Friday.
Exactly. All right, Rich, I am sipping wine to your house as we speak. And but thank you so much for that. And, you know, I might try, at least at the sundown portion. I like Friday night, putting my phone on the charger and being like, all right, I'm done with work right now. Although, now that I am the emergency station for KFI, I kind of got to leave it on.
How am I supposed to do this, Rich? I know. You have a work excuse. You have a note from your work that says I can't participate.
All right. Rich, thanks so much. I appreciate it.
You got it.
See ya. That is KTLA's Rich Shamiro. Follow him on social media at Rich on Tech. His website is richontech.tv. You know, when we were having the discussions of, you know, hey, we're going to put a studio in your house and, you know, and how it would, you know, help the station. And if, you know, overnight something breaks, literally, bam, you know, I'm there. I got it, you know. It sounded like such a great idea and such a great opportunity until you really start thinking about it. You are on call 24/7, 365. You're never not on call. I guess unless I'm not home. Maybe that's the key. Maybe I should just be out and about. You know, I should start a podcast like Jen in SoCal. And I'll be in Ventura, and oh, something happened.
Yes, I know.
What, do the dogs take over the broadcast? I don't know. It could be very hairy, you guys, but anyway. So if you wonder, as Handel mentions a lot on Fridays, why I am there, it's because I am literally testing the station's emergency studio every Friday. Got to make sure that thing keeps working, right? All right, when we come back, we're going to talk with infectious disease doctor Simone Wiles. We haven't talked with her in a while. Are we emerging from the COVID-19 woods? If you look at the number of infections from this new Omicron subvariant, you might not think so. But then if you look outside, you see all these mask mandates being lifted, right? But are more people really ready to settle into a sense of normalcy? Or are there still some people out there who say, I kind of like these COVID restrictions. Let's just leave these in place for a while. We'll find out when we talk with Dr. Wiles in just a moment. But now let's take a look at your drive. And Dave's checking out the 14 in Palmdale.
Northbound at Rancho Vista Boulevard, you've got a crash blocking the right lane. It's a car facing the wrong way. Watch out for slowing there. Granada Hills, that brush fire still burning. 5 northbound at Roxford Street, that's off to the right shoulder. Crash in Carson, the 405 northbound at Carson Street, the carpool lane is blocked. And some trouble in Ontario, the 10 eastbound at the 15, you've got a 2-car crash off to the shoulder. 10 westbound after Milliken, 2-car crash off to the right shoulder there as well. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Dave Joseph.
Whether you're already on Medicare or soon will be signing up for Medicare, just navigating Medicare can be overwhelming. So let me suggest contacting AGA Medicare Options and get educated about all the rules before you make any of these decisions. There is a free dinner and educational Medicare seminar, no enrollment fees, no sales. So leave your checkbook at home. And this is with AGA. AGA's team of experienced agents will advise you step by step on a plan that fits your unique situation and budget, because we're all different. And AGA will help you find plans that are accepted by your physicians, cover your medications at the lowest out-of-pocket cost. Call to attend a free seminar near you. Dial #250 on your cell and just say, My Medicare. #250 on the cell and say the keyword My Medicare. Or visit agamedicareoptions.com, agamedicareoptions.com.
SoCal weather from KFI, sunny today, highs around 70 at the beaches to the mid-80s inland. cooler starting tomorrow with a chance of showers through Saturday. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
Regrow your own natural hair with the same simple one-day treatment that I received from Advanced Hair Restoration. Get a free consultation, $250 off, and 250 free hair grafts by calling 844-333-HAIR or advancedhair.com.
Hey, it's Jennifer. Join us this March to Make March Matter for Children's Hospital Los Angeles. Make March Matter makes amazing things happen for sick kids. It's a month-long event that takes place right in your neighborhood. So every time you shop, dine, or attend an event at a participating partner, they'll donate funds to support Children's Hospital Los Angeles. It feels so good to give, and saving lives is everyone's business. For more information, visit MakeMarchMatter.org. That's MakeMarchMatter.org.
I'm Susan Owen, managing partner at Owen Patterson & Owen. I have 30-plus years in personal injury alone. If you are a client of Owen Patterson & Owen, I will be your attorney. If you've been injured, call 888-OPO-WIN. And we do. Go to OPOLaw.com.
How can you best navigate the new world of work? Find out at the virtual California Conference for Women March 2nd. Speakers include author Brené Brown, civil rights legend Dolores Huerta, singer Mary J. Blige, and top workplace and personal development experts. Register at CAConferenceForWomen.org.
As the experts in transmissions for over 50 years, there's nothing at AMCO we haven't heard.
So when I hit the gas,
it's just a belt.
And nothing we can't fix.
It's going,
what's that? From transmissions to brakes and everything in between. No credit, finance your repair at AMCO. Exclusions apply, may not be combined with any other offer. Limited time offer, participating centers only. People who know go to AMCO. AAMCO.
This is Jacob Amrani. If you've been in an accident, call 844-24-JACOB.
Okay, stand by. KFI, AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Welcome to this Wednesday. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee. Thanks so much for being with me. Here's the latest news on the invasion of Ukraine. Ukraine State Emergency Service says over 2,000 civilians have been killed in this first week of war. Now, the Associated Press, ABC News are all scrambling to confirm that number. But if it's coming out of Ukraine State Emergency Service, you have to assume that they know more, right? And so that is the official number coming from Ukraine this morning. LA County Health Director Barbara Ferrer says she's waiting for the CDC to rate the county's risk level so she can order an end to indoor masking, and she told the Board of Supervisors the county's not yet ready to go with the state's new health order, which lifted most indoor masking yesterday. And a car crashed into an apartment building in Long Beach. Two people, including a child, were hurt as the car went through the wall and into a unit last night just before 10:30. The driver fled the scene. 5:53, we'll talk with ABC's Ike Jotzi about Russia, Ukraine, gas prices, inflation, the border, funding cops, all of the themes that stuck out of the President's State of the Union address last night. Right now, welcome back to Wake Up Call Infectious Disease, Dr. Simone Wilds from South Shore Health in Weymouth, Massachusetts. Dr. Wilds, good morning to you. Are we emerging from the COVID-19 woods?
Good morning, Jen. I would say that we are definitely picking ourselves up, crawling out, and getting to a better place. I feel very excited that we're in a different place compared to where we were a few weeks ago, where we were in the midst of a surge. Now we're easing the mask guidance. I mean, you see people walking around without their masks. I feel like there's a new day coming.
The only concern that the tiny little gray cloud that hangs out over there is this new Omicron subvariant that seems even more contagious, I guess, than we were seeing with Omicron.
Yes, Jen, there is the new subvariant, the B2. We do know it's more contagious. But, you know, what we have found, it doesn't seem to cause as much severe illness as the initial Omicron variant so far. And the other good news is, you know, we have a lot of people vaccinated and boosted, And that has really helped in making sure that we don't have the significant spikes that we saw with the original Omicron.
And I would think that if somebody is vaccinated and boosted, even knowing that this subvariant is out there, they're going to feel comfortable taking off their mask. They're going to feel comfortable getting back into some sort of routine of normalcy because they're going to feel protected.
Yes, and that is true. And one other thing that I want to add to that is if you happen to be vaccinated and boosted and you got infected, your immunity is very strong. And so the odds of you being reinfected are very low.
Oh, that is good news. Okay, I know that ABC News and the Washington Post recently did this poll that said even though Americans are going to be allowed to get back to some sort of normalcy, and mostly they were talking about, you know, taking off masks and things like that, that there are still a lot of people who are like, you know, I don't think I'm quite ready to drop these COVID restrictions. Even though I can, I may still wear a mask. I may still do the 6 feet social distancing, that sort of thing. So maybe even though you get the opportunity to do it, have we all sort of had this drumbeat, I guess, that we've been marching to for so long now, for a couple of years, that we've decided, you know, maybe that is kind of weaving into a new normal for us?
Yes, Jen, you know, I've had a lot of patients and even friends say they're not ready to take their mask off. And one of the things we tell people, you know, we are not saying you absolutely, you know, we are all going to get there eventually, but if it's taking a little more time to get your mask off, that's okay. You know, as we would say, there's no shame in to wearing your mask. The key thing is that, you know, if you are as an individual in a county or place where the numbers are low, it is okay to take your mask off, but I don't think we should point fingers at those who are still a little reluctant. And also, we don't know what people's underlying medical conditions are that puts them at higher risk.
Absolutely. Nobody knows what goes on underneath somebody else's skin, that's for sure. I was surprised this weekend. I spent the weekend with my nephews, and they're 6 and 8, and they wore masks everywhere. It was so normal to them. And I started thinking, you know, the six-year-olds have had masks on since they were 4. This is the life that they know. And for them, wearing a mask seemed as normal as putting on their shoes.
Absolutely. And I will say, Jen, I have a daughter who continues to wear a mask at home, even though I told her she doesn't have to. I feel, you know, they've gotten so used to wearing masks at school that they think it's like an everyday thing, a normal routine for them. So it is going to take some work to get some of the children out to the mask, and a lot of other parents are experiencing the same thing.
Absolutely. Dr. Wilds, it was nice to talk to you again. I hope we do it again soon.
Yes, take care. Be safe.
Thanks. You too. See you later. That is infectious disease Dr. Simone Wilds from South Shore Health in Weymouth, Massachusetts. I did think it was interesting, though. The boys were like, you know, we'd go into a restaurant and, you know, mom and dad and I and my brother and his wife, everybody took their masks off. And the boys sat there with their masks on, like as the waiter was coming around. And it was fascinating to me that this is just normal to them. That's ordering a pepperoni pizza to them. It means that they didn't think one way or the other about it. And I sort of liked that because even though a couple of times I did hear Auntie Jenny put your mask on, and normally it was in places I needed a mask and didn't know it, they noticed nothing about whether we had masks on or not at the table. And I kind of liked that innocence about it because I know you know people who mask shame one way or the other, either for not wearing or for wearing. It's just ridiculous. And kids, it's just part of everyday life. Gotta put my socks on, gotta put my mask on, whatever. I don't know. I do like what Dr. Wilde said. It's gonna take some people a little bit longer. Who cares? Who cares if the guy next to you in the store has a mask on or not, and he doesn't have to? Does it hurt you any? No. Does it make him feel better? Sure. Does that harm you that guy feels better? No. It's just ridiculous. All right, let's get back to some of these other stories coming out of the KFI 24-hour newsroom. LA County Health Director Barbara Ferrer says she's waiting for the CDC to rate the county's risk level so she can order an end to most indoor masking. She says there'll be some exceptions.
Masks are required for everyone using public transit, for all of those in emergency shelters, healthcare settings, correctional and detention facilities, homeless shelters, and long-term care facilities.
Ferrer told the Board of Supervisors the county is not yet ready to go with the state's new health order, which lifted most indoor masking yesterday. I bet she's going to get some criticism for that because she's going to be asked, I have no doubt some reporter out there is going to say, but wait a minute, what do you mean that the county's not yet ready to go with the state's new health order? You've known that this was coming forever. What makes LA County different than any other county? I look forward to what her answer is on that because I know that's a question a lot of people have. Almost three quarters of Californians have had the COVID-19 vaccination, but a California Department of Health report says far fewer have had a booster shot. LA and Orange counties are near the state average. Black and Latino residents have had the lowest vaccination rates in the state. LA City Councilman Kevin De Leon says a new plan will help fight illegal trash dumping, which he says has gone way up in recent years.
Neighborhoods and commercial districts are right now struggling with the problem of illegal dumping, which not only blights their communities, but also draws in other illegal activities.
The plan approved yesterday, it's called Clean Streets Now, and it calls for cleanup crews to respond to reports of trash within 48 hours. Stronger enforcement strategies are expected from the council at a later date. A city report shows illegal dumping in public areas increased 450% between 2016 and 2020. California snowpack. I'm glad Hamble's not listening. I can see he doesn't have his monitor on. It's 63% of average. The state's January and February were the driest on record. Governor Newsom is asking everyone in California to cut back water use by at least 15% compared to the 2020 levels. I was driving from the Bay back to LA this weekend, and all along, I don't remember seeing this many water signs along the way. There used to just be a few kind of dotted along I-5 as you went through the Central Valley, but now it's sign after sign that says, Governor Newsom, quit wasting our dam water, D-A-M water. And it's just sign after sign after sign. You know, every few miles, you run into one of these signs. But you understand that these different farmers who are out there are saying that they've had to cut their crops already because they're not getting the water allocation that they're used to because of the drought. So, the fight for water is high right now. 15 horses and a goat have been killed in a fire in Harupa Valley. 8 horses were able to be saved Monday. The woman whose family leases the property where the fire happened says her husband burned his arm while escaping the fire with their 3-year-old son. Former Congressman and presidential candidate Beto O'Rourke has won the Democratic nomination for governor in Texas. The man who has the job, Greg Abbott, won the Republican nomination yesterday. Abbott is running for a third term. Oh, if you're going to see the Batman this weekend, the Dark Knight could empty your wallets before the lights go down.
AMC Theaters says it's charging higher prices for some movies, including the latest Batman flick. Prices will vary based on the bigness of the movie, but tickets for The Batman this Friday at AMC in Burbank are $1.50 more than other movies released recently. AMC says it's been a bold speaker in the area of pricing and has been charging more for some movies in European theaters for years. It apparently believes it can recover from the pandemic with aggressive expansion. It's been buying up former Pacific and Arclight theaters. It also recently announced it would be selling popcorn at retail. Michael Crozier, KFI News.
When we come back, we'll talk about the President's State of the Union speech with ABC's Ike Jassy. Everything from Russia to inflation to gas prices and funding the police. Will anything change following the President's remarks last night? We'll find out in just a minute. Right now, let's take a look at your drive, and we're checking out the 10.
Westbound after Millican Avenue in Ontario, a two-car crash off to the right shoulder. And the eastbound side of the 10 and the 15, you've got a two-car crash there on the shoulder as well. Carson, the 405 northbound at Carson Street, crash blocking the Parkview lane. And in Palmdale, the 14 northbound at Rancho Vista, accident there blocks the right lane. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Dave Joseph. I've been drinking coffee like 6 times. Today, you know, Caffeine Awareness Month. Woo-hoo, I'm super aware. And now, the top 5 reasons to visit Morongo. Number 5.
Get a break on spring break. Get a room, 20 bucks of free flat play, and access to the Oasis Pool for as low as $129.
Number 4.
Fresh brewed giveaway. Get a pick-up coffee maker when you earn 500 points on your reward card. The 7th or 8th.
3.
Art of Rap Live featuring Ice Tea, March 26th. Get your tickets now.
Number 2.
Fast Friday giveaway. You can win up to $750 in free play every hour, 1 to 8 p.m. Playing slots with your rewards card.
And the number 1
reasons.
The marketplace is coming. The marketplace is coming. The marketplace is coming.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Less than 90 minutes from wherever you are. Morongo. Good times.
This report is sponsored by CalHope.org.
The more we learn about COVID-19, the more questions and worries we have. CalHope can help with free COVID-19 emotional support. Call 833-317-4673 or live chat at calhope.org today.
It's Colin Cowher. Here's what's trending for iHeart Sports Network, presented by Mercedes-Benz.
The Clippers continue their hot streak by beating the Rockets for their fourth straight win. They face the struggling Lakers tomorrow, who rallied from a 21-point deficit but couldn't finish off the Mavericks last night. It's their sixth loss in the last seven games. And for the first time in 27 years, Major League Baseball games were canceled over a labor dispute. Each team's first two series have been scrapped as the lockout continues. I'm Misty Jordan.
Hey, rocket scientists, look no further for the next big thinker. First-in-class technology, a leader in innovation, and an intelligence not yet seen from an SUV. The 2022 Mercedes-Benz GLE. Learn more at MBUSA.com. Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing.
Hey, all, it's Dean Sharp. There is nothing worse than getting ready to relax in a hot shower and then stepping into an ice-cold one. If that's you, you need to call Water Heaters Only. Water Heaters Only has been replacing water heaters since 1968 and doing it with same-day service, the best products, the lowest prices around, and for a limited time, 0% deferred interest financing. So call the company that does Water Heaters Only. Visit waterheatersonly.com, get a new water heater with zero interest. Terms and conditions apply. That's waterheatersonly.com.
The Ridiculous Crime Podcast proves that true crime isn't always about mayhem and murder. Sometimes it's just silly. Take a deep dive into the absurd side of criminality with tales of stupid capers and idiotic cons that are 99% murder-free and 100% ridiculous.
16-year-old Max Wade decides to steal the yellow and black Lamborghini Gallardo Spider. The owner? You know him as Guy Fieri.
Listen to Ridiculous Crime on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts.
If you own a business and manage to keep five or more people on the payroll through the pandemic, there's a new government program that will pay you tens of thousands of dollars per employee. And this is not a loan. This is a grant. The challenge is getting your hands on this money. This is a bureaucracy. InnovationRefunds.com cuts through the red tape, helps you get the cash. They do all of the legwork. They don't charge a penny until you receive the money, and what they do is simply share a percentage of the money they get for you. They got my business a six-figure refund. Now, their average client gets $250,000. That's impressive. Go to InnovationRefunds.com, click on the Qualify Me button, answer a few questions. InnovationRefunds.com, it's no risk, and it certainly is high reward. InnovationRefunds.com, they help me, I'm sure they can help you. InnovationRefunds.com.
Someone uses your toilet and it overflows. Can you imagine how embarrassing that is for your guests and for you? Hello, I'm John Okoyan, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. You're hosting a party, the water's on the floor, and your guest has to tell you that the toilet is backed up. And worst of all, you have to tell your guest that they can't use the bathroom. I shudder when I tell this story because it happened to me. Can you imagine? I own Rooter Hero Plumbing and my toilet overflowed. Talk about being humbled. Well, the truth is, it could happen to anyone. And the solution is to call 866-DRAIN-77. That's what I did, and our plumber was here within the hour. Not because I'm the owner, but that's just what we do. I'm so confident that you'll be satisfied with our services that I put my cell phone number on every business card. 866-DRAIN-77. That's 866-DRAIN-77.
Most of us have a favorite song or soundtrack as motivation for when we need it most. And no matter which beat we choose, one thing's for sure, music inspires us all. Let's use the power of music as inspiration to reclaim our rhythm. Today, let's start one healthy habit that works for our life, for the best chance at life. Join me. The American Heart Association is ready to guide us every single step of the way. Reclaim your rhythm at heart.org.
Portions of the following program were pre-recorded.
Live and unscripted with L.A. County Sheriff Alex Villanueva.
I'm a firm practitioner in servant leadership. I believe in an evidence-based decision-making.
Sunday nights at 8.
I do not tolerate corruption in any form, and I hold my personnel accountable to the rule of law.
L.A. County Sheriff Alex Villanueva, live and unscripted.
This Sunday evening at 8
on KFI.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Welcome to your wake-up call on this Wednesday. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee. Here's the latest news on the invasion of Ukraine. Russia is taking new steps to contain the financial fallout from its attack on Ukraine starting today. People are banned from leaving with more than $10,000 worth of foreign currency to try and protect the economy. Russia also has been banned from competing in international ice skating events that includes the upcoming World Figure Skating Championship. Let's say good morning now to ABC's Ike Adjachi. I want to talk more about President Biden's State of the Union speech last night, which Ike, as you know, started with Russia and Ukraine, the situation there, and the president had some tough words for President Putin of Russia.
President Biden starting his speech and really offering strong words of support as well to the Ukrainian people and their president, Volodymyr Zelensky. Now, President Biden praised the strategy of standing lockstep with Europe and NATO allies in imposing harsh sanctions on Russia and its president, saying Putin's attack on Ukraine was premeditated and completely unprovoked. And then the president made some news, announcing that the U.S. would ban Russian airlines from American airspace after Europe and Canada took similar steps. We saw President Biden spend about a fifth of his speech talking about the Russian invasion of Ukraine, and we also saw a rare showing of bipartisan support. We saw every member of Congress, Republicans, Democrats, Independents, stand up and applaud President Biden several times as he was making several points and offering support to the Ukrainian people. And it was an important showing of unity, not only for the United States, but to the rest of the world, that the United States is completely unified in their support for Ukraine in the middle of this crisis.
And I thought, too, that it was striking that the president really wanted to hammer, hey, look, we are not sending U.S. troops in to fight Ukraine, but we will send them to defend our NATO allies should that need to happen. And then also saying that, basically that there was more to come. In other words, President Putin, if you think that this is all that's coming your way, you ain't seen nothing yet.
That's right. We saw President Biden still telegraphing his moves in terms of further sanctions and further actions. And then we also saw him speaking about further actions in terms of supporting Ukraine. Right now, the United States, they have given about $1 billion worth of support to Ukraine right now. Over the past year, in terms of weapons, arming those frontline defenders as they're trying to defend their country, and we're also seeing the president still take harsher actions against the Kremlin. And it's not just the president; several companies are doing so too. So Apple and Google removed their mobile pay services in Russia, as well as several other companies and entities really just moving away in terms of airlines and even entertainment companies. I mean, we saw Disney hold the release of certain theatrical releases in Russia, really everything coming together in terms of the global economy to try to suppress Vladimir Putin's actions right now, as he seems almost unhinged in his attack on Ukraine.
Following the president's comment on Russia and Ukraine, we went into then the more local themes, and specifically inflation and how the president plans to combat that. And it seemed to be his real message was buy American.
That's right. You know, President Biden, he came out and he admitted it. He took ownership, saying that, I get it. Saying too many families are struggling to keep up their bills and inflation is robbing them of gains they thought otherwise they'd be able to feel. And he said his priority is getting prices under control. But a lot of those proposals, it's going to rely on Congress. And it's a Congress that hasn't been able to pass much of his social spending proposals. President Biden emphasized boosting domestic manufacturing, just like you were saying. He was calling for some specific items that would have been part of his stalled Build Back Better plan. But we saw President Biden call on Congress to cut costs for prescription drugs, combat climate change in order to lower energy costs, He was asking Congress to lower the cost of childcare and, of course, instituting free universal pre-K among many other initiatives.
I think the one thing when he was talking about the 60 million barrels of oil that were coming out of the reserves to help us, I think the thing, it sounds good if you think about it on paper, but we use almost 20 billion barrels a day, so that's only about 3 days worth. I thought that, you know, while he had some great ideas, how they were going to, the longevity of those ideas, whether it be the fight in Congress or whether it be that it was simply just a Band-Aid literally for a few days, I think a lot of people were wanting more to see behind those plans.
And that was some of the qualms that were raised with the Republican response. They were saying that, they were blaming President Biden not only for spending for inflation, but, like, as you said, not doing enough to really address these gas, these rising fuel prices. And we have to understand, these rising fuel prices, they're going to do a lot more than set the prices at the pump. Obviously, we know Russia is integral in supplying not only Europe with natural gas, but in America. We still are buying 700,000 barrels from Russia every single day. But it's important to know, and I really want to make this, this is also going to affect food prices. Here's two reasons why. Russia and Ukraine, they make up 30% of the world's wheat exports. And also, natural gas is a huge component for fertilizer, which we know is a crucial item in the agricultural industry. But President Biden said this is a chance for stirring just new industries coming together in the United States in terms of possibly fertilizer production ramping up here in the States. But in the short term, you're going to see that those effects really hit prices in the grocery store, something that the president really didn't offer much of an answer to in last night's State of the Union address.
Ike, thank you so much for your time. We'll do it again soon.
Thanks for having me.
All right, see you later. That's ABC's Ike Adachi. This is KFI and KOSTHD2 Los Angeles. Jeff Baugh, good morning to you. Let's check out the 101.
Wow, good morning, Jen. Before we got to start with a big, big problem here. Now, please listen up if you're trying to leave the San Fernando Valley. First, the 101 is okay, except, a big except, for the transitions, east and west 101 to the south 405. Here's the big problem. We're over and over right now. It's south 405 before Mulholland, about halfway up the hill. Only the carpool lane is open. Terrible crash. Fire department had a really tough time getting there, but they're on scene now in big numbers. Now, south 405, as you know, it doesn't take much. It's already stopped somewhere, but well, in between Sherman Way and Roscoe. That's really getting to the ridiculous point so early. So over the boulevard now is still good, but that's going to last about another 15 minutes. That'll go down the tubes as well. If you can get on this south 405 at Valley Vista or up the top of the hill, Mulholland, any of that, you're okay all the way down the hill. Boys, this is a big, big problem. More coming up. Don't go away. Jeff Ball, KFI in the sky.
It's just a question of time for interest rates really climb. I mean, that the Fed has already told us this. So what's going on with your home mortgages if you want to take some money out of your house and put it to work because you've got equity in your home doing nothing? Your property values have climbed. So interest rates are very low still, historically low. Money is still dirt cheap. Why don't you borrow against the equity? And now's a great time to do it. And then put the money into an investment or home improvement. It really doesn't matter. HMS Capital is a company I'm recommending. I've done two mortgages with them. They're the only lender I know that actually encourage you to apply with other lenders at the same time. They're that confident they can get you the best deal. Call 833-255-5698. 833-255-5698. Visit hmscapital.com.
HMS Capital Funding is a DBA of Columbia Empire and Canada, ID number 2427. HMS Capital is licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation. Under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. License number 413030. Equal housing lender.
Hi, this is Joe Cordell with the law firm Cordell & Cordell. When the prospect of divorce becomes a reality, you need a partner that you can count on. If you're a man in this situation, consider contacting Cordell & Cordell. We've helped men navigate complex legal matters for 30 years.
Contact Cordell & Cordell to schedule an appointment with one of our firm's California attorneys. 1455 Frazee Road, Suite 500, San Diego, California, 92108. Online at CordellCordell.com. That's CordellCordell.com.
Hey, all, it's Dean Sharp. Sunluck is my solar company, and here's yet another reason why. Tesla. Yes, that Tesla. Tesla has awarded Sunluck special preferred access to the entire newly released Tesla solar ecosystem. That's the panels, the mounting system, and the most sought-after solar component, the Tesla Powerwall battery. It all amounts to the most advanced solar in the industry, and it's all waiting for you at sunlux.com. That's sunlux.com. CSLB 100837.
This is Jacob Amrani. If you've been in an accident, call 844-24-JACOB.
SoCal weather from KFI. Sunny today with highs around 70 at the beaches to the mid-80s inland. Cooler starting tomorrow. Clouds come in and we do have a chance of showers through Saturday. We leave local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Jennifer Jones Lee. This has been your wake-up call. Handle on the News starts now.
Handle on the News.
These are rough, rough.
And now, here's Bill Handel.